Hey everyone, this is Garmadon Attack, a Scholastic brand activity book. I might call it a booklet. It's very thin, but I pre-ordered this off Amazon when I heard that it was coming out. And here we go. Based on the Ninjago movie that's coming up, hasn't been released as of the time of this video, has some nice comics in here, some nice drawings that I think are pretty cool and that a lot of kids will enjoy kind of getting immersed into. They have some decently interesting activities to go through. Nothing too advanced, of course, but you know, it's just for fun and to keep the brain going. I think this is the most challenging of them and the most interesting looking probably as well. But of course, I did not get the book for the activities. That's a pretty cool one as well. And I'm not going to take you all the way to the very last page because this is cool. If we get into the answers, let me just make sure I don't show you the answers. There's one more spread here. And then beyond that, it gets into answers. I won't show you any more except for just that half there. But of course, I did not get this for the activities. I got it for the figure. It's Cole. Ah, Cole, my man. What have the mad people behind the Lego Ninjago movie done to your hair? Oh, how can you live like that? Seriously, what have they done and why? Just why? Oh, you're not quite connected. There we go. That's so much better. No, it's not. Interestingly though, the hairpiece, though it is very matte in appearance and has a lot of shaping to it, is hard plastic. It's not a rubbery piece. I thought it was going to be a rubbery piece. Okay. Just black and the dark brown there, got the top knot on. Very high quality printing, especially for kind of a lower end mass market minifig like this that's probably not made in one of the main Lego factories. It's probably one of those that's contracted out, just like the collectible minifigures are. This looks good to me. Especially the print. It's not super intricate, but it's crisp and clean. Everything is just on point with the positions. Maybe that little spot down there isn't quite so perfect, but I don't know what the design is actually supposed to be. But yeah, this looks good to me. And of course we have to look at the faces. Now that's a little bit more of a recognizable face, if you ask me. I think that's a little bit better. I think I like that one better with the hair on as well. Yeah, definitely. I definitely prefer this for sure. Yeah. The other face with nothing on there. Hey, that actually works pretty well too. It's just the hair. It's the hair that messes him up. I don't know, it's gonna take me some time to get used to that. Now this hair piece is dual molded, so it's not just painted on there with the dark brown, but the faces on the figure I think are good. Hair is of course gonna take some getting used to. Maybe just leaving it partway on like that. Does that help? Nah, I don't think it does. I think it's important to show his eyebrows, but yeah, either way, funky. Oh, it is what it is. And this is his new main weapon, the big old hammer there. Looks like it, I think in universe it's supposed to be metal, but here it looks like stone. You can kind of see it as being stone as well, but they tend to show it as being metallic. Not sure exactly which way they're going to go with that. Of course, it would be more appropriate for it to be stone-based for Cole, but that's just that. My first time having my hands on any actual merchandise from the Lego Ninjago movie, which is a perfect time for me to go on to a rant, which is also unintentionally going to separate out folks in the comments who have watched the video and who haven't, because this is indeed the first thing that I've gotten from the Lego Ninjago movie series. Because LEGO has not released the sets for the LEGO Ninjago movie anywhere except at LEGOLAND stores, at least in the United States. And I find it just infuriating as a big fan, not just as a reviewer who needs to, you know, bring content to viewers like you on a timely basis, but as a fan, like I'm really looking forward to those LEGO Ninjago movie sets because they look fantastic to me. Most of them look just far above the norm for Lego stuff, you know, non-advanced Lego stuff, just regular stuff. so many cool parts as well, so many cool building techniques, just really good looking stuff all across the line. I want those sets and I can't get them. It's bad enough that Lego releases different things at different times around the world. Like sometimes the UK will get things maybe a couple weeks before the US, maybe 3 months before the US, and you know, Europe and Asia will get stuff, or the US or North America in general will get stuff like 3 months before the rest of the world, 6 months before Australia and New Zealand. That's really frustrating. And I feel for all the folks who are caught on the wrong side of that, on the waiting side of that. Because here I am caught on the waiting side of that again. And I'm in a region, a country, where Lego is going to release this stuff on a timely basis. It's all intended to come out on August 1, and you know, some retailers will put stuff out sooner. But why Lego Land and not Lego stores? I would be cool with it if they brought it out at Lego stores and you could also buy it online as well, but no, only Lego Land stores. And I don't live within 16 hours of Lego Land stores, so I can't get the rest of the sets without just paying scalper prices on eBay. So that's why this is the first and only thing that I've gotten my hands on from the Lego Ninjago movie series, answering a lot of questions that a lot of you have been asking me. Just kind of wanted to wrap that in here. It's just a good chance for it. But that's that. Thank you for watching. I look forward to actually being able to get my hands on those really cool sets as soon as I can, but can't buy them until they're available somewhere I can actually buy them. So thank you for your patience. I'll try to be patient too. I'll talk to you again soon.